free. Do you know what you go tell me? Say nobody go die.
Check like your camera money for can't hear.
Sorry, follow up.
So the vice president came to survey the area. He just came in. There are so many people around here to figure out what's going on.
So the gas was still
in the air like that, about 15, 20 minutes away. So the whole area was silent, meaning people were lucky to escape. Attendant. So when it started, I thought they should have found some measures because there was no fire around that time. So I was there trying to go close to it when still the gas was just in the air and then on the ground until it got to some kebab seller there. He also left his fire with his kebab. So the fire, the gas just got fire and then traveled back to the vehicle. The vehicle discharging gas. So there the vehicle was burning. It was only the vehicle that was burning like that. The heat was too much. So then that it traveled back to the pump itself where they are discharging to. So it was still burning like that. Big time burning. I was around.
Nobody called the fire service.
In fact, I really thank one police officer who was around at that point. I don't know where he came from. So he just made us here. But he saw everything. So he was with their phone to call the fire service. So he told us they respond to his call. So they start. We have been waiting for a while and then we are not coming until the first explosion. It just exploded and then the fire was just around there like that. So it was the second explosion that the fire waves just started. Seriously. So it just burst here. That time I was also around the way I saw it in the house. So I was also going to hide myself somewhere. Fast.
Yes. We showed up to the students just by those fires in the petrol station. We prevent further spread of the fire and further explosion from other tankers. With the gas filling station, you can see it's totally damaged. There were a lot of fire involving it. The bulk oil vehicle that is also on fire was also built on fire. So we tried to confine the fire on the bulk vehicle. So this morning, that this 6 a.m., we finally totally extinguished the fire on it. And we continue to have cooling process on it to ensure that the boiling gas we need will not result in further explosion after it. Though there is no fire, because the gas is still boiling in it, there could still be an explosion. That is what we've been doing for the case about 5 minutes ago. When we further went ahead to reopen the valve in there to allow the rest of the gas to escape. However, with a gas tank, though the majority of the gas is off, we still have particles of gas in it. That is why you can have the sound that is allowing the remaining insignificant gas in the tank to.
So what I just gave you was the aftermath of what happened at Atomic Junction, the explosion, and my condolences to those who lost their lives, and my sympathy to those who were injured, to those who lost their family, their friends. Everything that happened there was nothing interesting, nothing fun. And I know a lot of things are going through your mind. A lot of things are going on in my mind too. How can a gas station and a filling station be on the same lane, like right next to each other, and another one right opposite both of them? It's insane. And there's another construction of a filling station going on right beside the one that just exploded. So something needs to be done, yes. But we should also know, just in case something like this happens, the first thing we should do, don't ever think you can do anything by yourself. Just call the fire service. That's the first thing we need to do. So thank you for watching Wunti Tells You. See you next week. Do not forget to subscribe. And just in case you have questions or suggestions, do not forget to put them down